3,742 crores, an increase of rupees 18,064 crores over the revised estimate for 12-13. Ordinary working expenses have been fixed at 96,500 crores, that is 14% higher than the current year, and appropriation to the pension fund at rupees 22,000 crore. Based on the likely requirement of planned resources for renewals and replacement of railways assets, the appropriation to depreciation reserve fund has been kept at rupees 7,500 crores. The excess left after payment of dividend calculated at 4% would be appropriate to development fund, that is rupees 3,550 crores, capital investment fund, rupees 5,434 crore, and the newly created debt service fund, rupees 4,163 crore. The operating ratio is expected to improve to 87.8% from the revised estimate of 88.8%. We expect to close the year 2013-14 with a balance of rupees 12,506 crore in the railway funds. Annual Plan 2013-14. Madam Speaker, the Annual Plan 2013-14 has to be integrated with the broad objectives and targets set for the 12th Plan. Yet we must be realistic in setting targets in the Annual Plan 2013-14, even if it means that railways would be faced with a stiffer challenge of enhancing investment during the remaining 3 years of the 12th Plan. A plan investment of rupees 63,363 crore is proposed for 2013-14. The plan is proposed to be financed through GBS of rupees 26,000 crores, railway shares in road safety fund of rupees 2,000 crore, internal resources of rupees 14,260 crores, market borrowings of rupees 15,103 crore, and an expected mobilization of rupees 600 crores through the PPP route. The thrust of the plan is on doubling of tracks, safety and passenger and staff welfare, for which I have increased the outlay from about rupees 11,410 crores in 2012-13 to rupees 13,220 crores, an increase of 16%. I would also like to thank the Minister of Rural Development for agreeing to the request of railways to partner in some of the railway-related activities under Mahatma Gandhi NREGA.